way we write is Brandon, who sings and plays bass, usually comes to the table with like a batch of ideas, chords, melodies, and at that point we all kind of dive in, figure out the arrangement, work on, you know, tempos and whatnot. And we hadn't gotten to that part yet, and that's Ben quit right then. So to a certain extent we were able to kind of start from scratch right out of the gate, instead of like having to take a few steps back because he quit. You know, I don't think any of these songs he had any active part in, other than probably a couple of ideas that he probably heard during the 10 silver drop sessions. When Ben quit, it didn't come to my mind, but when Brandon just was like, hey, how about Phil, it was just like, oh yeah, perfect. You know, this guy's really into kind of like what we're into. It's kind of like Ben, a very psychedelic guitarist. But the, I guess the one difference is Phil is that he plays guitar. He, you know, whereas Ben was just so talented, he played everything. Mm-hmm. And I think he wanted to do it all. Mm-hmm. And we just needed a, you know, guitar player.
While the wind carries,
we just let the music speak. Kind of like just bring to the table what you would bring, your style, mm-hmm. your sound. And then let it develop like that, as opposed to trying to create something. I think on the last record, you know, we were actually really trying to do a lot of stuff, and it was really cool. It was a lot of fun. But on this one, it's like, man, we just want to make a rock record. Mm. You know what I mean? It's kind of like we were watching the, I guess AFI had the top 100 flicks of all time. You know, and you get to the top 10, and in the top 10, there's like, there's musicals, and there's like Raging Bull, and there's all these crazy movies, and it's like. You know, and it's one of those, you know, those things where it's like not everybody's into musicals, you know what I mean? But a lot of people love all the types of movies, you know? And this record is like the Raging Bull. It's just like this gritty, dirty rock album, and it's not really a musical. It's not going to be for everybody, but it's really straightforward rock, and that hasn't been done in a while. We're aiming towards self-titled, or no title, which will be self-titled, is what you guys will referred to it as. We're leaning towards having this one particular song, The Fire Is Waiting, be the first song. And it's a hell of a beast of a song.
So we're here in Electric Lady Studios. I mean, is it kind of cool to be somewhere where Jimmy was? You know, I guess,
yes.
where he lived?
Yep.
Is that right?
He actually lived up this part of the studio. I don't know how long he lived here. I'm sure he hung out and partied here. Downstairs was his studio. And yeah, it's really great. It's kind of like, you know, you move to New York and you really struggle to do this band thing and you get lucky and catch a break, and then next thing you know, you're walking to Electric Lady to work on your recording. Yeah, it's really kind of fun and exciting. You know, it's kind of cool.